Welcome to Hello English Teacher. Today let's look at the second part of the line by line explanation of the chapter The Hack Driver from class 10 English. If you are watching my video for the first time, please subscribe. You can listen to the explanations of chapters from classes 10, 11 and 12 English. And don't forget to press the bell icon so that you get notified whenever I upload a video. Let's move on to the video now. So we saw how both Bill and the narrator had gone to the pool room. What is a pool room? A place where they play the game of pool. Pool game is something like billiards. So they went there also and they looked for Oliver Lutkins. But people told that he was here just 5 minutes ago and so they couldn't get him there also. So now let's see what happened next. I was hungry, but I had enjoyed Bill's rough country opinions about his neighbors that I scarcely cared whether I found Lutkins or not. So it had already become 1 o'clock and by that time the narrator was feeling hungry. But he says that he forgot his hunger because he was enjoying Bill's talk, how he commented about the neighbors and all that. So he was not feeling hungry at all and at the same time he was not bothered to find Lutkins. He was actually enjoying Bill's talk. How about something to eat? I suggested. And then slowly the narrator asked Bill that whether they could eat. Let's go to a restaurant and I'll buy you lunch. So he said, I'll buy you some lunch. Well, I ought to go home to the wife. So immediately Bill said, no, I have to go home and eat. My wife will be waiting for me. I don't care much for these restaurants. Only 4 of them and they're all bad. Tell you what we'll do. So he's saying that, no, I don't like to go to these restaurants here. And only 4 restaurants are there in our countryside here. And none of them are good. So I will tell you what to do. So Bill suggested what they should do. We'll get the wife to pack up lunch for us. She won't charge you more than $0.50. And it would cost you more for a greasy meal in a restaurant. So what is Bill suggesting? He's saying that he will ask his wife to pack lunch for both of them. And he also is charging $0.50. And he's saying that you'll have to pay more for a lunch in a restaurant. And we'll go up to Wade's Hill and enjoy the view while we eat. And he also suggested that let them sit on the Wade's Hill so that they can enjoy the beauty of the surrounding area and eat their food. I know that Bill's helpfulness to the young fellow from the city was not entirely a matter of brotherly love. So he was wondering why this fellow Bill is helping a man from a city. So he thought it's not only brotherly love that he is showing, there is something more to it. I was paying for time. In the end, I paid him for 6 hours, including the lunch hour, at what then was a very high price. So he said he had to pay for the lunch and also the 6 hours he had traveled with him. Remember, he had bargained to pay $2 per hour. So like that, he paid the total price. But he was no more dishonest than I. I charged the whole thing to the firm. So he's saying that just like him, I'm also a little bit dishonest person. So what does he mean by he was also dishonest? Instead of he paying from his pocket, the narrator says that he charged the whole amount to the company so that the company would pay for him because he is traveling here for the sake of the company to find that person. But it would have been worth paying him myself to have his presence. But he's saying that the money that I gave is worth paying because I enjoyed his company. His cheerful country wisdom was very refreshing to a country boy like myself who was sick of the city. And he's saying that whatever he talked about the countryside, it was so interesting and it is something new for me. I am from the city, so I got to learn many new things and I got a lot of information about the countryside as well. So he was feeling very happy to have spent some time with Bill. As we sat on the hilltop looking over the pastures and creek which slipped among the trees, he talked of New Mullion and painted a picture in words of all the people in it. So as they were sitting on the hilltop after the lunch, they were looking at the beautiful sights around the pastures, that means the green fields, and the creek is the small stream that goes which slipped among the trees. Among the trees there was a small stream, and while enjoying these beautiful scenery, he was talking about, he was describing all the people who lived in this place called New Malian. So Bill was describing about all of them to the narrator. He noticed everything, but no matter how much he might laugh at people, he also understood and forgave their foolishness. So Bill was making fun of everyone, but at the same time, although he made fun of them, he was able to forgive the foolish way in which some of them behaved. He described the minister's wife who sang the loudest in church when she was most in debt. So he was also talking about the minister's wife who was in debt. That means she owed a lot of money to somebody, but then she was not bothered about it and she used to sing loudly in the church. He commented on the boys who came back from college in fancy clothes. So he was also making fun of boys who wore fancy clothes. That means all colorful clothes, etc. He told about the lawyer whose wife could never succeed in getting him to put on both a collar and a tie on the same day. And he was also making fun of a lady who was the wife of a lawyer and who was not able to dress him up properly. That means wear the lawyer's collar as well as the tie on the same day. He made them all live. That means he explained them in such a way that the narrator could actually see them in front of him. So lively was his explanation. On that day, I came to know New Malian better than I did the city and to love it better. So from that day onwards, after listening to Bill's description of the place and the people, he started understanding this New Malian more. And he's saying that he understood it more than the city where he lived. And he also began to love the place. He began to love the place, New Malian. Bill didn't know about colleges and cities, but he had traveled around a lot of the country and had had a lot of jobs. So Bill did not know anything about the city. Who is Bill? Bill is the hack driver. He does not know anything about the city, about colleges and all. He does not know. But he has traveled most part of this countryside and he did a lot of jobs as well. So that is why he was able to describe this countryside and the people in the best manner. From his adventures, he had brought back a philosophy of simplicity and laughter. That means after listening to his explanations, he understood that he followed a philosophy of simplicity and laughter. That means he was a humorous man and he loved simplicity. He strengthened me. That means he understood that he got a good friend in Bill. We left that peaceful scene of meadows and woods and resumed our search of Oliver Lutkins. So the narrator saying that after the talk, both of them got up from there and they continued to search Oliver Lutkins. We could not find him. At last, Bill cornered a friend of Lutkins and made him admit what he guessed. Oliver gone to his mother's farm, 3 miles north. And so finally what happened? Bill was able to find one of Oliver's friend and asked him. So what did that friend say? The friend told them that Oliver Lutkins might have gone to meet his mother and he must be at his mother's farm, which is 3 miles north from here. So we drove out there laying plans. I know Oliver's mother. So they started going towards Oliver Lutkins' mother's farm. And then Bill told the narrator that he knows Oliver's mother. She's a terror, Bill sighed. I took a trunk out there once for her. And she almost took my skin off because I didn't treat it like a box of eggs. So the hack driver is explaining about Oliver Lutkin's mother to the narrator. So he is telling her that she's a terror. That means she is very strict, a lady who does scream all the time. So once what happened, Bill had to deliver a box, a big trunk means a big box to this lady. So when he took the box to the lady, she started screaming at him and telling that you should treat it like a box of eggs. He might have treated it very roughly. So she was telling him to treat it very softly. That means not do any damage to the box as if eggs were there inside. She's about 9 feet tall and 4 feet thick and as quick as a cat. And she sure can talk. So she's a huge lady. So he's just telling that she's 9 feet tall and 4 feet thick. So she's tall and heavy built and she's quick as a cat, means she can take any action immediately and she can sure talk and she also talks very nicely. So she's a lady who reacts very quickly and people are really frightened of her because she's really a terror. Albert Oliver heard that somebody is chasing him and he's gone on there to hide behind his mother's skirts. So Bill is telling the narrator that maybe Oliver has come to know that somebody is looking for him. So he could have gone to his mother's house so that he could hide behind her skirts. Well, we'll try her, but you'd better let me do it, boy. So he's telling the narrator that, we will try and find him there, but then you should allow me to do the talk and search because you will not be able to handle her. So that is what he was meaning to say. You may be great at literature and law, but you haven't had a real training in swearing. So Bill is telling the narrator that you may be from the city, you may be educated, and you may be a lawyer, you may be a man coming from the city with all the knowledge, but then you haven't learned the real thing. That means you don't know how to swear at people. So that is how people in the countryside are. They just talk very roughly. And since you are from the city, you will not be able to handle such people. We drove into a poor farmyard and we were faced by an enormous and cheerful old woman. So they reached Oliver's mother's farm, and he's describing it as a poor farmyard. So it is not looking very well kept. So, and they saw a enormous and cheerful lady. A huge lady was there and she was looking quite happy also. And that should be Oliver's mother. My guide bravely went up to her and said, "Remember me, I am Bill Magnuson, the carter and hackman." So he went close to that lady and told her, "Do you know me? My name is Bill Magnuson. I am the carter and the hackman. I want to find your son, Oliver." So he told her that we are looking for Oliver, your son. "I don't know anything about Oliver and I don't want to," she shouted. "Now look here." So the lady, what did she say immediately? "I don't know anything about Oliver and I don't want to know about him also." So look here, we had just had enough nonsense. This young man represents the court in the city and we have a legal right to search all properties for this Oliver Lutkins. So immediately Bill told the lady that, "See, we have had enough nonsense. We were looking for him all over the place, but we couldn't find him. And this is the young man," he said, pointing towards the narrator, "that he is from the city and he represents the law, the court." And he also told her that he has all the rights to search every property belonging to Oliver Lutkins because he has come in search of Oliver Lutkins. Bill made me sound very important and the woman was impressed. So the woman started looking at the narrator because she was quite impressed by what Bill told her. She retired into the kitchen and we followed. She seized an iron from an old-fashioned stove and marched on us shouting, "You search all you want to if you don't mind getting burned first." So what is the lady, what did she do? Immediately she went into the kitchen. She brought out an iron rod which was quite hot. And she showed it to them and said that, you can do all the searching, but first you must get burnt. I'm going to beat you with this hot iron." So she was threatening them. She did not allow them to go and search. She shouted and laughed at her frightened retreat. So she was laughing the way how the narrator and Bill ran away from their retreat, means running back, because they did not want to get burnt with the iron rod. "Let's get out of here. She'll murder us," Bill whispered. So what did Bill say? "Come on, she's going to kill us. Let us escape from here." "Outside," he said, "did you see her smile? She was laughing at us." So after reaching out of the farm, Bill told him, "See, did you notice that she was only laughing at us?" "I agreed that it was pretty disrespectful treatment." So they did not get a respectful treatment from Bill's Oliver's mother. "We did, however, search the house. Since it was only one story high, Bill went around it, peering in all the windows. We examined the barn and stable and we reasonably certain that Lutkins was not there." So they were quite convinced that Oliver Lutkins was not to be found in the farm also. "So it was nearly time for me to catch the afternoon train and Bill drove me to the station. So it was time for him to take his train back to the city. And so Bill dropped him back at the station. On the way to the city, I was very little worried over my failure to find Lutkins." So he was feeling sad that he was not able to find Lutkins. "I was too busy thinking about Bill Magnuson." So he was only thinking about the hack driver whose name is Bill Magnuson. Really, I considered returning to New Malian to practice law. So he had fallen in love with that place so much. He also liked Bill Magnuson and he was only dreaming about coming back and settling in New Malian and starting a law firm. If I had found Bill so deep and richly human, might I not grow to love Fritz and Gustav and 100 other slow-spoken, simple, wise neighbors? So he's thinking, see, if I can love Bill, I could also love all the other people who are very simple and wise in the countryside. So he wanted to return to New Malian and start a law firm there and practice law independently. I pictured an honest and happy life beyond the strict limits of universities and law firms. So he did not like the life in the city. So he wanted to come out of it and have a happy and honest life in the countryside. I was excited. I had found a treasure. So he was so happy that he had this new plan with him. I had discovered a new way of life, but I did not think much about Lutkins. The office did. So because he was so engrossed about this new plan of his, he did not bother much about not finding Lutkins. I found them all upset. But then next day when he went to the office people were really angry with him because he had gone to the countryside to catch hold of Lutkins, but he was not able to catch hold. So they were all upset with him. Next morning, the case was coming up in the court and they had to have Lutkins. I was shameful, a useless fool. So they were so angry with him, the office people, because the next day was the case and Oliver should be there in the court. So they had not found him. So they were really angry with the narrator. So he was feeling very shameful and he was looking like a useless fool. That morning, my promising legal career almost came to an end before it had begun. So the narrator understood that they were going to chuck him out of his job because he was not able to do the job what they had given him. So he thought that his career had come to an end. The chief almost murdered me. So he got nicely from his chief. He hinted that I might do well at digging ditches. So he shouted at him and told him that you better go and dig ditches. That is better than what you're doing now. I was ordered back to New Malian and with me went a man who had worked with Lutkins. So the chief ordered him to once again go to New Malian to fetch Lutkins. And this time another man was accompanying him. And that man very well knew who Lutkins was and so that he could really find Lutkins and bring him along with them. I was rather sorry because it would prevent my loafing all over again with Bill. So he was feeling sorry that he had to take this other man with him because he won't be free to move around with Bill Magnuson how he had done last time. When the train arrived at New Malian, Bill was on the station platform near his cart. So when they reached New Malian, again the narrator saw Bill Magnuson was standing near his cart. Strangely enough, that old tigress Lutkin's mother was talking and laughing with Bill, not quarreling at all. But then he was shocked to see that the old lady, that is Oliver Lutkin's mother, was standing with Bill and talking to him in a nice manner. They were talking and laughing. From the train steps, I pointed Bill out to my companion and said, "There's a fine fellow, a real man." So the narrator, after getting down from the train, he showed his friend who was with him. "See, look there, he's a very fine man and his name is Bill. I spent the day with him. He helped you to hunt for Oliver Lutkins?" "Yes, he helped me a lot. He must have. He is Oliver Lutkins himself." So immediately the friend who came with the narrator told him, "Oh, is this the person who helped you to find Oliver Lutkins?" Immediately the narrator said, "Yes." And immediately the friend who had already worked with Oliver Lutkins told the narrator, "He is only the real Oliver Lutkins." That means Oliver Lutkins had been fooling the narrator, telling that his name is Bill Magnuson. So really, Bill Magnuson is Oliver Lutkins. So who identified this? The man who came with the narrator from the city identified and told him that this is Oliver Lutkins. What really hurt me was that when I served the summons, Lutkins and his mother laughed at me as though I were a bright boy of 7. So he took his summons from the court, the letter, and gave it to Bill Magnuson. Now he understood that Bill is Oliver Lutkins. So he felt very bad and hurt because they were laughing at him because they had cheated him yesterday, and thinking of that, he was feeling really bad. And he was feeling as if he was a small boy who had been cheated. With loving kindness, they begged me to go with them to a neighbor's house for a cup of coffee. So both of them, Bill and his mother, they requested the narrator to go along with them to a neighbor's house to drink a cup of coffee. I told them about you, and they are anxious to look at you. So what is the lady telling? Yesterday, not lady, it is Lutkins who is saying. So what did he say? He said, yesterday I told my neighbors about you and they are very anxious to see you, said Lutkins joyfully. They are about the only folks in the town that miss seeing you yesterday. And see how he is making fun of the narrator. He is telling that, see, my neighbors are the only people who did not see you yesterday. That means the whole countryside, people in the whole countryside saw the narrator along with Oliver Lutkins. So he is saying that only the narrators, the neighbors of Oliver Lutkins did not see this narrator. So he is saying, let's go there and have a cup of coffee. So in this way, this is how Oliver Lutkins cheated the narrator. So we saw the theme, how appearances can be deceptive. So you should not go only by the appearances of a person. You should be able to use your intelligence and identify the real person. So this is what happened in this story. The man called Oliver Lutkins called himself as Oliver Lutkins and told the narrator who had come in search of him that he was Bill and helped him to search Oliver Lutkins all around so that he was able to escape for one day. But next day he was caught because the other man came along with the narrator from the city and identified him. But he and his mother only made fun of the narrator as to how they had fooled him for one day. I hope you liked today's video. For more informative videos, do subscribe to Hello English Teacher. Like, share and give your valuable comments below. Thank you for watching.